Hello everyone and welcome back to my channel. Today I want to talk to you about cleaning orchid leaves because a little while ago I made a video on using mayonnaise to clean orchid leaves and get rid of deposits and put a nice shine on the leaves. And I got a lot of surprising comments because I did not expect it to be a controversial video. But a lot of people reacted rather strongly actually. There were a few people who told me that my orchids would die. They said that it would block the stomata of the plant and it would no longer be able to breathe and so synthesize and thus it would die. There were also people who were concerned about the orchids burning because oils can act as a sort of lens for the sun to intensify and then burn the leaves. And yet others just thought it was gross because it's mayonnaise. Well, and despite all those concerns, I've been using mayonnaise as an orchid shine or orchid cleaner for almost a year by then. And all of my orchids were doing fine. There were no adverse effects for as far as I could tell. Everything's growing normally. They're growing. So photosynthesis is obviously a thing that's happening. And occasionally a bottom leaf falls off. But I really highly doubt that's due to the mayonnaise. Because bottom leaves fall off more often. And it's more a nutritional issue than anything else. But that's a different topic in and of itself. I just brought this plant out to show you. I uploaded that other video in September, halfway through September, which is now almost 2.5 months ago. And as you can see, all of these leaves are looking splendid. They are shiny, they are clean, they're not yellowing, they're not dropping, and certainly this plant isn't dying. And also there is no sign of any sort of sunburn anywhere. So clearly in my environment, mayonnaise is an orchid leaf shiner. Works just fine. There is no issue whatsoever. And actually, I would like to address some of the issues that people brought up, such as the issue that mayonnaise could clog the stomata and prevent gas exchange and thus prevent photosynthesis and growth. Now, I can imagine this could happen if you were to, first of all, use mayonnaise on the underside of the leaf and you stick it on in thick film in high amounts and don't remove it afterwards. Now, if you do these things, I could imagine that a physical barrier forms that prevents gas exchange, and this could naturally impact the health of your plant. I haven't tried this, I'm not going to try because it doesn't sound like a good idea to me, but in this scenario, I can understand how using mayonnaise to clean the leaves could potentially block gas exchange and photosynthesis. Now, this is not how I do it. As I show in the other video, I put a very thin film so that you barely see it over the top side of the leaves, never the underside, and that's it. And as you can see, I have no problems. The second concern, which I thought was more interesting, was that of sunburn. And like I said already, it is known that oils can focus the sun onto a surface, as you can see with tanning oils. I looked up some information on the internet, which I know is always a dangerous phrase to say, but trust me, I went through multiple sources and multiple websites, and I tried very hard to look at scientific journals, and of course I couldn't find any information in those, but I looked specifically for mayonnaise causing sunburn when applied to leaves. And of course I couldn't find anything, because that's a rather niche question to ask, and I doubt many scientists are scratching their heads over the question. What I could find quite a lot on, especially on marijuana growing forums, is the use of neem oil and sunburn. Now, apparently with neem oil, there is quite a large correlation between using it and your plants getting sunburned. However, one thing I found in all the threads is that it's not so much on the fact you're using it at all, rather than the fact that you're using a really great amount of neem oil, like really drenching the leaves and leaving them like that in the sun. And that apparently can cause sunburn. However, if you just use a light amount of neem oil and do not drench the leaves, then there's no danger and nobody gets sunburned anymore. So I'm extrapolating that data, saying that neem oil is similar to mayonnaise, which also has oil in it, which is the part we're concerned about. And I'm therefore going to say that there's no real concern of sunburn if you apply it in a thin film like I did. Of course, if you're concerned about this anyway, you could always use a very thin film of mayonnaise and then remove it from the sun for a couple of hours. On all of the forums on neem oil, everyone agrees if you just use however much neem oil you want and then keep it away from direct light for a while, a few hours, everything should be all right. Just as long as the neem has dried, so to say. With those kinds of concerns addressed, I want to get to the next part of the video, which is where I test several methods of cleaning orchid leaves, because several of you have expressed interest in me testing several different types of cleaning agents. And not everyone likes to use mayonnaise. Some people just think it's icky and smells bad, which I can understand. It doesn't smell great, even though after application you really don't smell it anymore, so don't worry about that. But even so, I thought even for myself, it'd be an interesting experiment to see the effects of different cleaning agents on orchid leaves. So with that said, welcome to the Orchid Spa. This is where we put the sparkle back into your orchid's leaves. And this is a bit of an experimental spa where we're going to test 7 different cleaning agents to see which one best shines and cleans these leaves. Now the residues you see on the leaves of this orchid are nothing to be concerned about. It's a very new orchid. It's a Tetraspis C1 that I got on Saturday. And just before I got it, the orchidarium, which is where I get almost all my orchids, had sprayed with some silicone to try and strengthen the leaves. So there's nothing to be concerned about. There's no pesticide, there's no issues. It's fine, don't worry about it. But it is ugly. And I've actually been reprimanded on Instagram for posting a picture of this orchid without cleaning the leaves, which, fair enough, I should probably get to cleaning it, but you know, we all have those lazy days. So today, let's get down to find the best method to clean these orchid's leaves. I just realized that this orchid doesn't really have enough dirty leaves to properly test all the substances on, so I've got a second orchid here to help us, which also has quite a few residues still left from when I bought it, because I've been lazy for a while now. Let me introduce the cleaning agents to you. So we'll start from bottom left, and here we have water with lemon juice, so diluted lemon juice, which is a very common cleaning method that a lot of people used. Here we have water with vinegar. Here we have mayonnaise, which I've already shown you, but I figured I'd use it anyway just to show the comparison with the other materials. Here we have olive oil. Here we have water with dish soap. Here we have milk. And here we have plain old water. Now I'll explain why I chose these materials to you. So some of those I chose because I've heard of people using them and having success with using them, such as the mayonnaise, which I've used myself and learned from other people on the internet as well. Diluted lemon juice, which is a more well-known material to use. Milk, which I've also read online that people use sometimes. And water with dish soap, which is also a known cleaning material that people use at home. And some people just use water. They just shower their orchids and that's all they do. And that works for them. And I've added 2 of my own, just for funsies. I have water with vinegar, so diluted vinegar, and olive oil. And the reason I've chosen these materials, these two, is because most of these materials have something in common. They have something acidic to help dissolve. And for the ones that really put some shine on the leaves, they contain an oil. So here I've got water with vinegar, which is just a diluted acid, really. And here I've got olive oil, which is just an oil. So I just wanted to try those two just to see if it's any different. It should be perfectly safe if I use them in small quantities and only on the top side of the leaf, as I've explained before. And honestly, the water with vinegar should not act any differently from the water with lemon juice, depending, of course, on how strong I've made them, which I did not check. I'm sure it'll be fine. Anyway, let's get to it. So I'm going to start with my Tetraspis. Now for the Tetraspis, I'm going to start on the left and basically go like this. So let's start with the water and lemon juice. So we get a cotton pad, you just dip it in there, squeeze out a bit, you don't want too much excess moisture. Pick a leaf, take this one for now. And you just gently slide a cotton pad over the leaf. It took me little to no effort, and everything seems to be clean right now. Everything seems to work fine. So far it looks like lemon juice works great. Now next I'm going to go with the water and vinegar. And we'll see how this works. Again, almost no effort, and the leaf is squeaky clean. Next up, we have mayonnaise. Now we've already used mayonnaise before in the past, so I'll move a little bit. And there we go. That's also clean and nice and shiny. And then I usually use the other side of the pad to remove any excess mayonnaise. There we go. Next, we go for olive oil. So this is pure oil. There's no acidity to olive oil, not really. I just checked with my pH meter and the olive oil has a pH of about 7.5, so almost neutral. So we have here with the olive oil is really just pure the effect from the oil, not from any acid helping it dissolve any minerals and deposits. So we just want a bit of olive oil. We take a leaf. I'm not going to take this one because it's the back of a leaf and we are working with oil here, so let's not be tempting fate. I'll take this one down here. And then remove the excess oil with the other side of the pad. You don't want to leave it wet and covered in oil, that's just not a good idea. That's nice and clean and shiny, almost took almost no effort as well. Next we have water and dish soap, which is a very popular one as well. For this one, I'll take this one that's been flopped over. There we go. Effortless, all good and all clean. Next we have milk. I believe I've used this once before in the past and it worked just fine, but let's see. There we go. Also worked. Maybe slightly more effort than the others, but barely. And then last, we have good old water. I think we've run out of leaves. There's this tiny one down here that's not actually really all that dirty. Can you see it? Here. I guess I can loosen that one and then also loosen up the oleaginosa. Alright, even that works. So it looks like you really don't need to overthink it. You can literally just use water. Now, this was only deposits of silicon, which are quite easy to remove in the first place, I think. So let's move on actually to the venosa, which still needs to be cleaned, which has some more stubborn grime on the sleeves. So I figured we'd use different materials on different spots of these sleeves to see how easily it removes the more difficult stains. So we'll start again with some water and lemon juice. Alright, that was really easy. I was actually very impressed with that. That was literally effortless. Great stuff. Next, I'm gonna go with some water and vinegar. And place that on the other half of this leaf. I feel like it was slightly more difficult than the diluted lemon juice, but only marginally so. And that could just be that the stains there were slightly more stubborn than the stains on the other half. But the results seem quite similar. So that's nice. Both of those work with the more difficult stains. Next I'll go for my good old mayonnaise. Now I need a small amount. And I'll put that on the first half over here. Yeah, works fine. No real issues. Everything's gone. But I feel a little bit less stains from this leaf than the other leaf. But everything seemed fine. Then we have the olive oil, which I'll put on the other side of this leaf. There we go. Also, no problems, no effort. Remove the excess with the other side of the cotton pad. Don't want excess mayo and olive oil. Then after that, we have water with dish soap. Ah, works beautifully. Look at that. All grime is basically gone. Let's see how much is left on the cotton pad over here. Yeah, no, that works great. I'm impressed. Then we have the milk. Okay, that was a little less effortless than the water with the soap, honestly. Took a little bit more time to get all the grime off, but I did get it all off, and the leaf does look very good. Ooh, interesting. See, I haven't even continued on to the last leaf yet, and yet these two leaves, where I used, I think, lemon juice and water vinegar respectively, although it looked clean while it was wet, so you can see now that it's drying up again, that it did not actually dissolve all the deposits, even though it looked like it when it was wet. So that's something to keep in mind. And then we have the next leaf with plain water. And again, you can see the green deposits on the cotton pad. Now let's give it about 10 minutes for both those orchids to dry again, and then we'll compare the results and see which of these cleaning agents actually worked the best. Okay, I think about half an hour has passed, so that's enough time for most of the materials to evaporate and show us how the leaves look when they've kind of dried up. Let's start with the tetraspis. Let's start with the first material in the first leaf that we did. This was the lemon juice leaf. As you can see, this leaf is fine. It's properly clean. There's no spectacular shine to it, but it kind of just looks normal. It looks natural. It looks good. So lemon juice seems to work fine on the tetraspis here with these silicone deposits. And then underneath that, we have the leaf with mayonnaise, which is also squeaky clean and has more of a shine than the one with the lemon juice, as expected, because it contains an oil. Then you have vinegar. That was this one. So you can see it's also properly clean. There are actually a few deposits here on the end that maybe I didn't try hard enough, and a few over here as well, which appear to be gone when the leaf was still wet, but now have become more apparent. So that's a little bit of a drawback maybe of those techniques. The shine is comparable to the lemon juice. Maybe it's slightly more shiny, but that could just be because it's... No, that's probably just because this is the newest leaf, so it's probably about the same. Then we have this leaf, which was cleaned with milk. And as you can see, it has a natural little shine. It seems to be properly clean. I don't see any leftover deposits. So milk works fine. Then you have dish soap on the one that got flopped over. And dish soap does not seem to have worked all that well, honestly. Like you can see here, there's a lot of deposits left. So I'm not very impressed with dish soap. I would not pick that over the other techniques I've used today. Now this leaf, ultra shiny, was done with olive oil. It looks perfectly clean. It does look very shiny, so you gotta like shine. But it looks perfectly clean, as a cleaning agent it seems to do its job despite not having any sort of acidity to it. And lastly here we have the leaf that was cleaned with water, which did not do as well. You can see quite a few deposits there still left on it. Let me make sure it's focused. There we go. You can see some deposits back here. For the rest, yeah, there's more deposits than the rest. It's better than I expect, honestly, but there's still something left over from the silicone residues. So those were the results on the tetraspis. And just show its beautiful flower. Yes. But these were relatively easy stains to get rid of. So now let's go on to hard mode, which is the venosa. So with the venosa, if you remember, we halved the leaves. We put one material on one side and then another material on the other side, which will help us compare a bit better as well, maybe. So on this leaf, this side was lemon juice and this side was water with vinegar. And you can see for both of them that it didn't really do the job. When it was wet, it looked clean, as you saw. And you also saw that before I even finished doing all the other leaves, it had already evaporated and you could already see that the residues were actually still there. So the lemon juice and the water and vinegar, you need to put a little bit more effort into cleaning this than I thought you would. Now I might have to do it the second or maybe even the third time. Then below that we had the leaf we cleaned with water. And we had the same issue really. It was only this half, by the way. This half was not clean at all. You can see it's better than nothing, for sure. But you still have residues over here, you have residues over here. It's definitely not perfect. Next we have the oily leaf. This one was cleaned with mayo on this side and olive oil on this side. Now, shine-wise, I see little to no difference. I think maybe the olive oil is slightly shinier, but it's marginal, the difference. But the most interesting thing is that you can see that there's no more sign of any deposits anywhere. This could be because of the increased shine, actually. Maybe the increased shine is kind of masking the deposits that are still there, whereas these leaves, which have fully dried, have nothing left to mask the deposits that are still left behind. But it definitely looks better, in my opinion, the oils. Then over here we have dish soap and milk. And here you see a good difference, actually. So here the dish soap, you can see a lot of deposits still left. Here in this whole ring actually is still left with deposits. But the milk is pretty good. I don't see many deposits with the milk anymore. Maybe very few here along the edge. But milk is good. Milk is a success, I'd say. And I think that was everything. I didn't use anything on this one. Yeah, that was all. Taking the results of these two tests into account, I would say that vinegar and lemon juice work really well with less persistent stains. So maybe when you have calcium deposits from hard water, or in this case, silicone deposits, it works quite well. However, with more stubborn stains, like algal growth on the leaves and those kind of things, it might be that you need something a little bit stronger. And in this case, olive oil, mayonnaise, and milk worked quite well. But vinegar, lemon juice, water, and dish soap did not. And actually, olive oil and milk and mayonnaise worked quite all right on the tetraspis as well. So from this test, I would say that the best functioning materials to clean your orchids with that you have lying around the household, because you have professional leaf shine materials and that kind of stuff, is milk, olive oil, and mayonnaise. The only real difference between them is that the milk is less shiny than the olive oil and the mayonnaise. So you can pick what you prefer there. You have them in a row here. One, this is mayonnaise, olive oil, and milk. You can see with the milk, there's no real extra shine added to it, only the natural shine from the leaf. So if you prefer that, milk's for you. But olive oil and mayonnaise, and especially olive oil, which is slightly more than mayonnaise, I feel, does give this extra shine to it. So if you like the look of that, you could go for one of those. But again, if you use the oils, make sure to wipe off the excess, because it's more likely to potentially be harmful than milk is, although I haven't had any problems with my plants yet. So there you have it, ladies and gentlemen. The winners of our test are olive oil, mayonnaise, and milk. So now hopefully you have all the information you need to go and give your orchids a beautiful shine they deserve. If any of you have any more concerns about the materials used or have any other suggestions for materials to use, feel free to leave a comment. And if you like this video, please give it a thumbs up. If you didn't like it and you think I'm abusing my orchids, go ahead, give it a thumbs down. And if you like the video and would like to see more of this kind of stuff in the future, go ahead and hit the subscribe button so you'll be notified whenever I upload a new video. So thanks for tuning in, everyone, and I'll see you next time. Bye!